Let's take a look at faults in Insight. Managing faults is done through the Faults tab in the Control Panel. In Insight, we have two general categories of fault items, faults and unassigned fault sticks. When picking faults, some people prefer to start by picking separate fault sticks and later to combine them into faults when the structure becomes more clear. These independent fault sticks are stored in the set of unassigned fault sticks. Once assigned to a fault, Insight will connect the sticks and draw a surface. Let's begin by picking a fault in the 3D view. Click the Add button in the top right corner and select New Fault. Give your fault a name and choose whether to pick in time or depth. To start making changes, enter Edit Mode by clicking the pencil icon. Left click to place the picks for a single fault stick. These picks are connected by straight lines. Right click on a point to remove it. Double click on a final point to finish the stick. If we set an inline and crossline increment, we can quickly jump between locations using the arrow keys. This can help us pick the fault at regular intervals and easily compare the current pick with the previous one. We want to pick this fault every 60 inlines and let Insight interpolate the surface between each stick. Anytime a fault is changed, Insight automatically updates the fault surface. You can pick a single fault on any view or combination of views. You're not limited to picking in a single domain. Here I have a series of unassigned sticks that I will combine into a new fault. Right-click the first unassigned fault stick and press the A key. This will assign it to the active fault in the control panel. Another way to assign sticks is to right-click and select Move Fault Stick to the name fault, in this case, Fault West. Note that the fault picks can also be edited here. Select each subsequent fault stick and press the A key to assign it to the current fault. Oops, that doesn't look right. Let's unassign that stick by pressing the U key. The Details panel holds all display settings for each fault. We can adjust the display of the intersections, surfaces, and sticks, as well as the color and thickness of the displayed fault. Click this button to show the computed surface. We could also remove all the sticks from the fault. In all section views, the computed surface is drawn as a dashed line, and any fault sticks that intersect the section are drawn as crosses. The map view has one extra setting. By default, Insight shows the intersection of the faults with the current time or depth slice value, shown here. In the Display tab, you can change to show where the faults intersect that slice or a horizon. If you have questions or would like to discover more, then visit our website at www.geo.com. And remember, have fun with Insight!